Hello students, today we are going to talk about the wind energy. So basically about the wind energy or unequal heating of the wind, we have already seen in the 9th standard. So unequal heating of the land mass and water bodies by solar radiations generate air movement and causes winds to blow, right? So we all know that the direction of winds to blow is depends on the heating. Unequal heating, right? Because as we all know that hot air are lighter in weight and it will goes upward, and while the cold air is heavier in weight and it will goes downward, and these solar radiations will cause the movement of the wind, and this kinetic energy of the wind can be used to do work, because moving air, which we are calling wind, having certain kinetic energy, and that kinetic energy we can utilize to rotate the turbine. And once the turbine is connected with the generator, then we can convert the kinetic energy into the electrical energy. So this kinetic energy of the wind can be used to do work. This energy was harnessed by windmills in the past to do mechanical work. So you have observed this kind of windmill, so many kinds of windmill you have observed, and especially near seashore, right? In our Porbandar, if you are go for the rung by air or any other area of the seashore, then you will observe the windmills, right? So basically what the windmill will do, so generally windmill convert the kinetic energy into mechanical work, and that mechanical energy will going to be converted into electrical energy. So for example, in water lifting pump, the rotatory motion of windmill is utilized to lift water from a well, right? So as we all know, the function of motor which lift the water from the underground storage, right? Today wind energy is also used to generate electricity. A windmill essentially consists of a structure similar to a large electric fan that is erected at some height on a rigid support. So as you all know, the structure of windmill, it is erected to some height with a rigid support, right? So to generate electricity, the rotatory motion of the windmill is used to turn the turbine. So as you can see, the this windmill will going to be rotated, and with this rotatory blade, a turbine will connected, and that turbine is also going to be rotated, right? Okay. So to generate electricity, the rotatory motion of the windmill is used to turn the turbine of the electric generator. So the turbine is connected with the electric generator, which convert the mechanical energy into the electrical energy. The output of a single windmill is quite small and cannot be used for commercial purpose, right? See, one windmill not able to produce that much amount of electricity which can be used commercially, but it can only produce the small amount of electrical energy. Therefore, a single windmill is not enough, and that is the reason we have to plant a number of windmill at the region or at the area where the wind is blowing fast. So therefore, a number of windmills are erected over a large area, which is known as a wind energy, which is known as the wind energy farm. The energy output of each windmill in a farm is coupled to together to get electricity on a commercial scale. So if you generate a wind energy farm in which a number of windmills will be there, and from that the electric energy that you are getting, it can be used for the commercial scale, because only a single windmill not produce that much amount of electrical energy that can be used for the commercial purpose. Wind energy is an environment friendly and efficient source of renewable energy, right? It is environment friendly because it does not create any kind of pollution, no doubt. When you need to plant the windmill energy farm, at that time certain biological or environmental component we are going to disturb, but still it is environmental friendly because it does not create any kind of pollution. So it requires no recurring expenses for the production of electricity, and also it is renewable because wind is not limited, right? But there are many limitations in harnessing wind energy. So what are that limitations? Firstly, wind energy farm can be established only एट दोज प्लेसेस वेर विंड ब्लोस फॉर द ग्रेटर पार्ट ऑफ अ ईयर. सी ऐसा नहीं होता कि चलो भाई पूरे साल में एक महीने तक विंड है वो ब्लो कर रहा है, बाकी महीने में विंड इतना ज्यादा ब्लो नहीं करता. लाइक मॉनसून सीजन है तो विंड ब्लो कर रहा है, लेकिन समर सीजन या विंटर सीजन में विंड ब्लो नहीं कर रहा. सो एट दैट प्लेसेस वी आर नॉट एबल टू कंडक्ट द विंड फार्म. वी नीड टू कंडक्ट द विंड फार्म एट ओनली द प्लेसेस वेयर द विंड ब्लोस फॉर अ ग्रेटर पार्ट ऑफ द ईयर. द विंड स्पीड शुड ऑल्सो बी हायर देन 15 किलोमीटर पर आवर to maintain the required speed of the turbine, because you have seen that the blades of the windmill are so large enough that a simple wind blowing cannot able to rotate it, right? Furthermore, there should be some backup facilities like storage cells to take care of energy needs during a period when there is no wind, right? So storage capacity like storage cells also be put in, so that what happened, we can store the energy, and when the wind is not blowing at that time, we can use that stored energy. Establishment of wind energy farms require large area of land. As you all observe the wind energy or windmill, you have observed, so you will have the idea that how much space it will occupy, right? For a 1 microwatt generator, the farm needs about 2 hectares of land, right? For 1 microwatt generator windmill, you require 2 hectares of land. And the initial cost of establishment of the farm is quite high. So it means its cost, it would be high. Establishment jo cost hai uski wo bahut zyada hoti hai. Moreover, since the tower and blades are exposed to the vagaries of nature like rain, sun, storm and cyclone, they need a high level of maintenance, right? So, uska maintenance bhi kafi zyada badh jata hai because it need to be protected from the rain, sun and storm. In that case, the maintenance will be high. So, this is about the wind energy, its advantages and its disadvantages.